Is Stenonymous.com?
Oh, that's actually a great question to ask. Stenonymous is what is a blog that my best friend Chris here has been running for, I'd say, the past at least 5 or 6 years, maybe longer. And it's for the field of court reporting. Stenographic court reporting is pretty much the only blog in the country. So I'm Chris's best friend, and over the years we've seen this effort to try to replace the stenographer, which is the live person. You know, the little old lady that sits
with what, like an electronic
recording? Yeah, exactly. They want to get rid of the human being and just tape record things and have somebody type it up later. And so that's causing it having a devastating effect in that we're losing people from the field, and then it's creating the misperception that the field is evaporating. And yes, there's a shortage, and there was a shortage beforehand, but it's now being exaggerated to a great extent by entities that feel that they can just completely do away with us and say, oh, there's no more stenography, it's gone, we'll just tape record it and transcribe it later. So that's what this whole effort is about.
Is there worries? And it almost makes me think of the same thing as like MLB baseball removing umpires and now trying to do it like fully automated with machines to determine balls and strikes, where it's like, I don't know, especially when it comes to court cases, especially if it's like a legal battle, you know, that could affect someone's life very strongly, I would feel way more comfortable knowing that like a human being is there like doing it, rather, because I don't know, who knows how things can be manipulated or what have you, especially for those that, you know, might not necessarily have the money to pay for like a good, really good attorney. You know, it could just be one other thing that feels like outside of their control, like the ability to realize you have like a proper human being caring for the facts and accuracy of court transcripts.
We hit so many issues, like the nail on the head. We call ourselves guardians of the record because that's exactly what we do. We listen, we speak up, we interject if we need to, if people are talking over each other. If you tape record something and send it off to be transcribed later and you can't hear it, you just put in audible. But we don't do that. We speak up and say, excuse me, would you repeat what you just said? And and everyone has a constitutional right to due process of law. So if let's say it's a criminal trial and they are convicted, whether they're guilty or not, that's not our function. Our function is to produce the transcript that's going to form the basis of their appeal. And that's too important to be left to technology that might or might not work.
No, I mean, that makes total sense. I mean, I feel like I'm a videographer myself. I shoot comedy shows, but I also help with post-production too, so creating like reels for Instagram and TikTok, which oftentimes have captions themselves.
Right.
And I found that it's a lot, I'm way more accurate and good with working on those Instagram reels if I was actually the person at that show shooting, so I'm able to distinguish between the voices and give the most accurate representation. Because during times where I have a video clip that I don't shoot, that's then passed on to me, and then I have to decipher that audio myself,
right,
I'm just going to make more mistakes. Like, I can say that with like complete accuracy.
It's amazing how analogous that is to our field. You're the one who was in the room at, let's say, a deposition where there's a civil lawsuit, and, you know, another individual is suing a company, or two companies are suing each other, or whatever the case is. If you were there, you have a better understanding of the context and of the lingo and the voices and who said what.
Right.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's even in social media, content creation is the same issue.
For sure, yeah. And I mean, especially a lot of transcriptions these days, I know at least in like the digital marketing and entertainment world, oftentimes are like sent overseas. So you have like random people that might be in like India or Pakistan that are like transcribing really important, sometimes important documents, and it's just like, what?
It raises so many issues. Confidentiality, first of all, who's listening to these hearings, what information is being divulged outside of, you know, like when you have a stenographer, we keep it in-house. We will sometimes work with a scopist or a proofreader who we vet, who we, you know, we hire and we interview and get to know them very well, so they know what we expect of them, and we know what kind of work they're going to do for us.
Yeah,
so
I'm curious, what's the training process like to become a stenographer? Like, what leads someone to get into that profession, I guess?
Well, first they have to be aware of it, so that's why we're out here, to just let people know it's still a very viable field, it's not obsolete, it's not going